Great people, great weather in this area. And we have some news today. An ant died, and there's an intense amount of homework in a certain class. Mention it later. But first up, right now, we have a group of people who are participating in a war and is written in a book called Dorothy Must Die. These people are the best of the best, and they are great at what they do. They work for the good side, and, well, most of them do anyways. But first up, let's meet the lady with the most amount of attitude, Amy Gunn. Okay, hello.
Hello, Jack.
Hello, Amy. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So, we have a few questions from the audience today, including one of them being, well, it's kind of halfway a statement right now. So, I've heard that recently Gert died trying to kill the lion. Was this a devastating loss to the Order?
Yeah, I mean, this was a devastating loss for me personally and for the whole Order. Gert was really special to us, and we had all of us had a really strong connection with her. She was the first person I met when I came to the Order and came into that cave, that dark, dark time when I escaped from the cell that I was in. And I felt like I had an instant connection to Gert and I could really trust her, and so it was a devastating loss for all of us and against our fight for Dorothy to die, and that's like one of the biggest things that had an effect on us.
Yeah, that is depressing. Next question is, how was spending 2 weeks in a different body?
Ugh, Jack, I gotta tell you, it was hard. I mean, you know, being in a different body, it takes some tolls. There's some weird stuff. And especially, like, you know, talking to the other maids and things, you know, if I ate something that was different or I ate something and talked in a different way than Astrid normally did, I would, you know, I was really scared that that was going to get found out as a different person. But, you know, when you learn from the other maids about what your character and what your person that you're impersonating does and how they act, and so I got to learn how Astrid really was.
That took a commitment, didn't it?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Alright, so our next statement slash question is, Dorothy's a pretty harsh person. How was it being so close to her?
Dorothy was a terrible person, I'm not gonna lie. Just a vile, vile human being. You know, combing her hair and what she did to Jellia was really kind of messed up. You know, she made her carry around a dead mouse in her apron for about 3 days, and it smelled terrible. So, I gotta say, she's just a vile human being.
That does not sound like the best of times.
No. I always felt like I was gonna, you know, probably get my face slapped or something.
Ooh, that is rough. Mm-hmm. Alright, well, that's about the last question that we had for you tonight. We want to say thank you for coming out tonight. It was a pleasure to meet you. Hello, Jellia. Welcome to the show. I must say I like your headband today.
Thank you. You really did my hair today.
Yeah. You know, it looks pretty nice.
Thank you.
Alright, so today we have a few questions from the audience. And the first one is, what was your relationship with Amy like?
Well, me and Amy had a pretty interesting relationship. So I was the head maid in the castle. She must not have thought much of me. Like, she probably just thought I was some random person that was, like, pretty loyal to Dorothy. But I was actually the undercover agent for the Order of the Wicked. So she must have been, like, I thought a lot about her, but she didn't think a lot about me.
All right. Oh, we have another one in. And what was it like bowing down for Dorothy for several years?
It was not fun, I'm not gonna lie. The Order of the Wicked said they'd only put me undercover for about 7 months, 10 years. happy with them. And also, like, I just don't like Dorothy at all. Like, she does executioning, her servants do whatever she wants, just immediately.
Not a good time, is it?
No.
It's not be fun. Another question is, what was working for the Order of the Wicked Light?
Well, at first, that was the right thing to do, so it was what I did. And, because I did not like Dorothy at all, how she was lust for power. So, I thought that joining the Order of the Wicked would help end that. But I just put undercover, and I wasn't really happy with them, because they said it would only be like 7 months, like I said before. Turned into years, so.
Yeah, too sure. Better to work for the good side, I guess.
That's true.
We'll consider it the good side. Our final question for you tonight, which is, why did you take the blame for breaking Mauda?
Well, I know that Dorothy was more important than me, and her prophecy was to kill Dorothy. Like, that was my, like, that's the main goal of the Order of the Wicked, is to kill Dorothy. So if, like, if I had to die for that, I'm willing to die. If Amy can kill me.
Well, that's a really nice cause. Well, thank you for joining our show today.
Yeah.
It was good to meet you.
Go back to scrubbing some floors.
Alright, and we'll hope to see you soon.
Have you ever felt like you're being left out by your friends? Like, you're just not equal with them? You're like, you're unhappy? Well, boy, do I have a solution for you. You gotta try PermaSmile, straight from Scarecrow's laboratory in the palace. It'll give you that extra kick to your mouth to make your friends like you more, get a better job, and most importantly, make Dorothy happy.
Welcome back to the Late Late Show, starring me. We have another guest coming in, but very shortly. Dueling is the new cool. Find out next on Discovery Channel. Now, the one who would soon rule the world. Take it away from us. I mean, take it away, Dorothy. Welcome, Dorothy, to the show.
Hi.
Okay, I'm pretty sure this is one of my questions, not from the audience like your previous guys. I've been wondering, I'm pretty sure others have been wondering this, is how does it feel being the ruler of Oz?
It's amazing. It's amazing feeling to like help my people like that. They needed me to rule them, and I just stepped up and did that, so it's an amazing feeling. Have whatever you want, and yeah.
Man, you're right. That does sound pretty nice. Speaking of my freaking parents. Another question is, this is from the audience, do you ever get suspicious something is going on?
Not really. I got a little suspicious after the lion was almost killed, but I didn't really get suspicious, maybe a little bit, but I never thought that the Order would, take someone, a little girl from Kansas, to try to kill me. I mean, come on, I'm amazing, and I don't know why anyone wouldn't want me as their ruler, so, yeah.
Yeah, alright. I mean, others have different, you know, beliefs about that. And our another question is, did you know about the Order of the Wicked?
I did. I never thought they were really powerful, though. And like I said before, I never thought they'd actually try to kill me with a little girl from Kansas. I mean, poor little thing, you know? They made her stay at my castle and dress up as another lady. It was just horrible.
Yeah, I can see that happening.
It's horrible.
Doesn't sound like the best of times.
No, just horrible.
And our final question for you is, most people have been dying to know. Why did you come back to Oz?
Why wouldn't you? I mean, who wants to tend to pigs and disgusting animals like that? I mean, why wouldn't you want to come back and rule it all? And like I said, my people needed me, so I just wanted to do it for them. And I didn't want to like be in the mud all the time, because pigs and horses are just disgusting. So why wouldn't you want to come back and just they needed me.
They got you. We got you.
Yeah.
Well, since that was your final question, we are so happy that you could come out and see us today. It was a pleasure meeting you. And off you go. Shoot.
No.
Our next guest up tonight is considerably the man of the hour, except for me, of course. Let's welcome Knox. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Got a nice group.
Thank you.
So, our first question from the audience today is, how did you help Amy get ready to fight Dorothy?
We trained her, me and the Order, we trained her as hard as we can. We got her into peak physical condition. We made sure that she was able to take on anybody, including the Lion, and especially Dorothy. We trained her with magic every day. We had the other witches training her very hard. And it was up to me to get her ready for combat, fist-to-fist combat. And I'd say I successfully did my job right.
Of course. And we saw her walking with a knife today. Do you know what that is from?
Yes, I gave that to her since the first time I known her to protect her, basically, from any sort of harm. It's enchanted. It could kill any sort of magic beast.
Wow, that is quite intense. So, I think people have been wanting to know this. How was your relationship with Amy?
Strictly professional.
I know, I've dusted this room yet.
Oh!
Aside from that, we, I consider her my friend, but we also know that we have a goal in mind, which is killing Dorothy and saving Oz, so we put that ahead of our friendship and our partnership.
Interesting. Alright, we have another question that just came up today. One second. What was it like working with the Order of the Wicked?
It's amazing. Without them, I would probably be dead. Since they saved me when I was very little, because my parents died, and since all my family was basically killed.
Interesting.
And without them, I'd probably be dead. My future was hopeless, and I had no friends, and they came and saved me, and they trained me. And now my ultimate goal is to defeat Dorothy and bring Oz back to what it used to be.
Alright, that is quite a substantial goal. What was it like growing up in Oz under Dorothy's reign? This is our final question for you.
It's not like what it used to be. It used to be flowers, poppies, monkeys everywhere is amazing, magic everywhere. But because of Dorothy, you know, my family died. All the towns were raided because of Glinda. She killed most of the people I knew. So, it was not fun. Jack, it was not fun. Yeah, so, because of the Order, it's my job to defeat Dorothy and train Amy, and hopefully we can bring back Oz to what it used to be.
I think that's a really nice thing to do. I think that is touching. I honestly think that if you try your best and do your hardest, I think that you might be able to get it back to normal.
Means a lot, Jack. Thank you.
Well, that was our final question for Knox. Let's give him a good old round of applause and let him piece the scene. So it ends up it's been really late and we don't have enough time to come back with that late news. We'll catch up on that next time. And thank you all for coming out, watching my show, and we hope to see you again soon. Thank you very much.